Hey guys, got a couple heaters going over here because it's going to get a little chilly tonight in North Carolina. They say down to about 10 degrees. Ooh, they delayed opening the schools for 2 hours, man. No precipitation though, just cold. but anyways, so I got to speak up. I got a couple of heaters over here kind of cranking away. But tonight I have a Christoph Ligero Maduro. Christoph. Christoph with a K. K-R-I-S-T-O-F-F. Let's see. Christoph Ligero cigars are patiently handmade in the Dominican Republic. At their core is a blend of well-aged Cuban seed, Dominican, and Nicaraguan long fillers, snugly nestled in Cuban seed, Dominican binders. Dark, oily Brazilian Maduro wrappers flawlessly surround the core. The cigars burn true, delivering a medium to full-bodied smoke informed by complex notes of dried cherry, coffee bean, cocoa bean, spice, and a sweet finish. This is a must-try cigar for the serious aficionado. Well, it looks great, just like they describe, you know, very kind of oily, dark Maduro wrapper. Feels great. Very densely wrapped there. All right, it's got like a little wrapped pigtail around there or something. That cut pretty easy, actually. I was thinking it's going to be very dense and hard to get through, but it did just fine. Fresh barn. I don't know, these damn things smell so similar to me. Well, it's really a great draw right off the bat there. Copious quantities of smoke. The burn is starting off to be a little crazy, but I think maybe that'll even out. It's kind of crazy in every other place, so maybe it'll fix itself there. I have my cold yet unfrosted glass. And tonight I'm going to be, let me get this freaking cigar out of the way. Tonight I'm going to be having a duck rabbit. The duck rabbit. See, it looks like a rabbit and it looks like a duck. You get it? You see right there? We've got two things happening, all right? Milk stout. Now, this is Duck Rabbit Craft Brewery, Farmville, North Carolina. It doesn't tell me the alcohol by volume, so it's anybody's guess. I'll look it up on Whatchamahoojadurwiget and see what they say. Pretty dark brown. Not too much of a head, but I usually kind of subconsciously pour to avoid a head. Kind of malty. Getting a little bit of metallic in there, it seemed like. And almost pick up a little milk flavor, actually, amidst the maltiness. Cheers. There you go. All right, I'll come back and see how this second third develops here. Hey guys, I just wanted to pop back in. Getting into the second third here, the burn is really razor sharp. It's excellent, and the smoke is does seem like it's a little sweet on the finish there. Okay, we'll come back as I get lower, but I just wanted to show you that ash there. Okay, another ash report. I'm plowing through the second third there. You can see what that ash looks like. Well, the ash fell off there. Getting close to that first label I'm going to have to take off there, I think. Still great smoke, doing well. Oh man, it's cold out there. Ran over to the house. It's probably like 50 yards or something. But it's getting chilly out there. So the beer I ran over there in the freezing cold to get was a North Carolina crafted Old Town Brown Ale, Natty Greens Brewing Company, Greensboro, North Carolina. Can you make out the dude? The dude. My cold and mostly frosted glass. And that is also kind of a dark brown, maybe a little reddish in there, I don't know. Nice little Unita glass. But it's a very good ale, very good brown ale. And where is that cigar? I think I'm going to wrap this up, but this is drifting into that last final third quite well. Very delicious smoke. I'd give it a try. Excellent burn, great flavor throughout. And thanks for stopping by. Appreciate it. All right, guys. Peace out.